Okay, so now I have finished the soles here, attaching them, and see, it just looks like a little line. Kind of reminds you of the tennis shoes, right? So here, these have dried the glue. Some people take them off, but then sometimes I find that you might get something getting stuck in here. So now I worked this sole. I used the 5mm hook. Now you're gonna go one, you don't have to, but it works better if you go down one hook size. So this is 4.5, just for the first row here, that when we attach here, then you could switch to the small, the regular size you had before. Here I'm gonna use a different contrasting yarn. Normally you could do whatever color. More than likely, I would have done these in white or all yellow. But here I'm gonna use a pink so you could see it. It's hard to film white. It doesn't come out really well. So here, I want you to attach your yarn on the outside, and then we're gonna finish attaching here on the outside. And the reason for that is that you don't want any seams or anything inside, because once you have your foot in there, it could rub and it could irritate your feet, your toes, especially like if you're diabetic, you wanna make sure you have a nice smooth area there. So here I'm gonna just prepare that by getting that little slip loop ready. Let me get this a little bit closer so you could see. Oh, let me show you first how I marked this, put my marks. So here, if you look at every, you're gonna have to figure it out, like every one of your flip-flops might be a little bit, their shape different. These I got, I like this brand because they're a little bit narrower, my foot's narrow. But here, I wanted to get the center of the flip-flop. So if I move back, beginning from the center here, if I go straight up, or pretty close to it, you could use a ruler even if you want to be more precise. I got here, and this was the center of the flip-flop, the front of the toe area. So right here, I put a stitch marker to help me count back so that I could have a nice wide band. Now, once you have this done, you could make other, you could do crisscross, you could do straps, whatever you want. Once you have this done, you're just gonna use these stitches here to attach. If you just wanted to do chains across, you could. I'm gonna do a strap so that it's a little bit sturdier, and because I want to add either flowers or, and I'm gonna show you how you can add some beads. So here, from this center, then stitch, I just counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the right, put a stitch marker, then here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the left, and then here I did 8 stitches, I believe it was. Let me see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on either side. And you could make your strap even wider if you want it. You can, whatever you want. Here, this is what I'm doing. So here, once I got my slip loop ready, I'm just gonna take that out. That way it's easier for me to get it all going. I'm gonna attach from the outside here. So I don't wanna work this way, because I don't want that bump or anything irritating your skin. So here I'm gonna stick in my hook in that first stitch. I can take off the stitch marker once I know where I'm in there. And then I'm gonna pull out my slip loop. Now, I'm going to sew this in at the end, because I don't wanna just weave it in or work it over my work, because it has a good chance of coming out, especially when it gets wet. So here I'm going to go ahead and chain one, and then in the same stitch right there, I'm gonna go back in and do a single crochet. And it feels a little awkward, your first one, and this is why I told you we needed to have these loops free. You're gonna do a single crochet in every stitch through both loops, not just the front loop or the back. So here's 2, you're gonna go all the way across. 3, and you can see here, let me see if I put it closer and you could see better. Jeez, you could see that the 2 loops are there. So here, let me go back down here. Sorry, guys. And then go all the way across. Now, the thing about this one, you can do your rows all single crochet, half double crochet, but I would not recommend double crochet, because it's going to be too big and cotton tends to stretch. So you want it kind of a little bit of a closer weave. It won't take you that long. You just have to be a little bit patient, I guess. I didn't think it took too long. But here, let me see. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, I guess I have more than 8. I guess I had 9. 9, 10. Oh, okay, I had 10 stitches. Sorry, guys. I thought I had done 8. So here I'm always almost at the end. And then I'm going to go into my last stitch. And you know, my feet are pretty narrow, so you're going to have to kind of figure out what is the best position. You could put your foot in there, like if you were wearing it, and then you could see like where your foot sits, where would you like your straps to do, and you could mark them if you don't want to do them this wide. Now when you come to the end here, you're just going to chain one, turn your work over, and then go ahead and do your next row. Now here, if you want, you could change to your larger hook, which is a 5, or you could continue working in this smaller size. I'm using the smaller one because I want it to be nice and close. When I get to the top, I'm going to add just a couple of beads, and I'll show you how to do that. The beads I have are just cheapy beads. They're not expensive ones. If you want some pretty ones, you could buy whatever kind. But I just expect to be wearing these outdoors. It's cotton. I'll probably wear them right on the beach because I live right by the beach. So if I get really fancy beads, they're going to get messed up. And these, I just have some little plastic cheapy beads. And you can use whatever kind you want. You could use the glass ones tend to break sometimes. So here, then, I'm going to continue to add rows. And see, you'll be able to see how it looks there on the side. I'm going to continue to add rows until I get maybe to here to the center. Then you could add some beads. But if you're not adding beads or anything, just continue to add rows until you, when you get this, if you just lay it down, it reaches here. Then once it reaches here, you can't do it just flat because your foot is not flat. So once it goes all the way to this edge, all your rows, it depends on how many you need. I think I needed like 15 rows when I did my other ones, but it was a different bottom. So here, once it gets to this side, I want you to go ahead and put it on the floor, put your foot down on there, and then put your strap, your top over like this. You're going to wrap it over. And then you want it to reach almost to the edge, but not quite. You want to be about, I would say about a half an inch, maybe a little between a quarter of an inch and half an inch short of reaching without stretching, just pulling it over. And I want you to be at least half an inch, yeah, around half an inch short, because this cotton stretches, especially when it gets wet. So if you make it right perfect, it's going to get loose as you wear it. It's going to stretch, and then your foot's going to kind of be too loose in there, so you want it to be a little bit short. I guess about, yeah, I would say at least like a half an inch or so. So here I'm going to continue doing a few rows, and then I'm going to come back and show you how to add a couple of beads. Okay, here I'm going to show you how you can add a bead if you want to. This is optional. You don't have to do it. You can also just crochet flowers, sew on buttons, whatever you want. So here you would get a small enough crochet hook. Here I'm going to put a white bead. So this is just a plastic bead that is okay to be in the water. So here, before I do my next single crochet, I want to get that bead onto the yarn. So what I'm going to do here, here's my hook where it's getting ready to do that single crochet. I'm going to get that hook with the bead, go into my next stitch. I'm going to pull that yarn up as if I was going to do my single crochet. I'm going to pull the bead through. See right there, can kind of split the yarn a little bit. And now I can just kind of lift that up, remove that hook, put my regular hook, and complete the single crochet. I want that bead to be on the outside, not on the inside. Once I do that, I can go ahead and continue adding my single crochets, and the bead will be held in place. I'm going to do another one here just to show you what that would look like. So here I have my next stitch, and let's say I want to put my next bead here. It doesn't matter wherever you want to put it. You could put the same color. You could put a hot pink. It's totally up to you. I'm just going to do random ones. And so here, once again, I put the bead on my hook. I'm going to go into that space, pull out my yarn like if I was going to do the single crochet. But with this crochet hook, I'm using this thin one to pull my yarn out. Once my yarn is out there, I can go ahead, stick it right onto my next stitch there and go ahead and finish through. I got distracted, guys. There's like a little piece of plastic there, so I'm going to cut that off. Maybe I'll use a little something to get rid of it. But these are just little cheap beads, so if you get fancy beads, that won't happen. And then here, you can continue to add your single crochets, and that is just how easy it is to add beads to a piece. You can do with or without them, totally up to you. Okay, guys, everyone. So here, I've just added some rows of beads. Remember, you can only add the beads on the top. You don't want them on the bottom, because if you're in the inside, it's going to, first of all, they're not going to show. They're just going to hurt. So here, once you do this, we want to connect on the outside, not here through the inside. So now I'm going to bring my shoe, my flip-flop, this way, and I'm going to attach through the outside. Now, I have already tried this on. As you can see, I tried it on before it reached there, and I needed to do a little bit more. And it is, if it's my foot, about maybe that much space difference where it's not reaching yet. So here, I'm going to go ahead and attach this. I'm going to bring that yarn here. It's kind of a little bit tricky there. So I'm going to bring in my hook on this stitch right there. I need to make sure I get both loops there. I'm going to grab that yarn here, and I'm just going to bring it through there, and I'm going to go ahead and get that there. Now here, it's a little bit different because we're working once again on the outside like we did before. I just did that one little chain, so I'm going to go through it again, go through both layers, and I'm going to start, same stitch, pull it through, and I'm going to do a little single crochet. If you want to, you can just do, no wonder I was having trouble. I had the wrong hook, guys. And nobody told me. Okay, so here, now I go to the next stitch right there, both loops, then work to the next stitch here, both loops. So you're going through both of them, bring it through there, and do your stitch. Go through this one, and the reason I'm not doing a slip stitch is because I want it to be a little stronger. So I'm going to pull it through here and do my single crochet. And don't worry, because when it's done, it's not going to look, it's just going to look like this. It's on the inside part of the shoe, so you're not going to really see it, but having that extra single crochet kind of makes it stronger. And then my last stitch, let me take that off. Right there into my last stitch. You should be all lined up there. And then once you do that, I know that that was the last one. So here, I like to do an extra one just to anchor that, just like I did in the beginning that I added it, then I anchored it. So once you do here, now that I'm there, I can go ahead and cut the yarn, leave a tail long enough where you're going to sew it. You're going to be sewing that in. So when you finish, now if you were sewing this through the inside, see from the top, it just looks like a little seam like this, and it's on the inside, so you can't really see it. If it really bothers you, you could even fold it down and sew it down. It's totally up to you, but I don't really think it makes that much of a difference there. This is what it's going to look like from the top. And now you can go ahead and remove all of your stitch markers. So you're going to repeat the same thing here with your other shoe. You can mark once again all your stitches, attach them there. And this color combination is kind of wild, huh? Yellow and gold, yellow and pink. I just did this so that you could see the contrast. It's hard to film white, which was my first choice. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this side, and then I'll come back, and then we'll do the heel portion. Okay, so here we have the front of our sandal done, and I just went ahead and added different beads, different rows of beads here. The beads are totally optional. You don't have to do that. And if you want, you could just crochet flowers or add buttons. Totally up to you. This is just something I did. Like I said, these are like the cheapy beads, plastic beads, so that I don't mind if they get wet. Or this is just going to be a sandal I just use around just outside walking for summer at the beach, so it's all nice and you can just wash it. I just sticking them in a little bucket and just swirling it around. So now here that we have this, we're going to start working on our little straps. Now here I'm going to get two little markers, and this is not like super scientific or anything. What I'm going to do is here, you want to get the flip-flop where it's getting narrow. See how this is like the foot part, and you could actually even put it on your foot. But around here, just a few stitches below where you started, I'm going to put in, I want my stitch markers, I'm going to put a stitch marker there, then go kind of across. It's not going to be exact. Okay, so, you know, here or whatever. But here, I'm just going to start right there. Put a stitch marker where the part starts getting narrow. See, you can see the stitch right here. It's starting to get narrow. So I put a stitch marker right there, a little bit below the narrow part. So here on this sandal, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 stitches below. But yours will be different. You just want to get it right there where it starts to get like a little bit narrow. And then you're going to get your yarn, and then I went ahead and I did 60 chains. Okay, you're going to do 60 chains. If your foot is a little like chunkier, you may need 65, but 60 should be okay. Once you do your 60 chains, in the space where you put that stitch marker here, I'm going to get a little bit closer so you could see better, hopefully. I'm going to go ahead, I have that chain. This is my 60, chain number 60. And then, oops, it got a little tight here. Let me redo that last chain. I don't want it to be so tight that I can't work my stitches in there later. So here's number 60. Then in that stitch marker, I'm going to go in from the outside, not the inside, always the outside. I don't want any harsh stuff in there. Let me just take that stitch marker out. Now I'm going to pull out my yarn. And I'm going to do a single crochet. One. And then in this next stitch, remember we had those three loops? Two. Three. And then four. I'm going to do four single crochets in the next stitches there. In those little side stitches there. So you could see it from the top. I want it to be nice and sturdy there. I don't want it to tear when I'm wearing them. I would hate that. So here is where it's going to be a little bit different for every person. I know I told you that my foot is kind of wide, right? Not wide. It's super narrow. I wear like narrow widths. I joke that it's the only part of my body that's still skinny. So you're going to come here and just try to find the kind of center, of approximately the center. And this is just the edges, so there's no actual clear cut place here. I'm going to put some photos here so you could see what I'm talking about. So here, it's this is about the center right there. Just to give me a place. Now for my foot, you're going to make a chain to connect from here to here. For my foot, it's super narrow, so I only needed 10 chains. Remember, this will stretch a little bit, so here. You might need more if your foot is wider or your arch is higher, the top of your foot is higher. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now my foot is pretty skinny, I hate to admit it. And here I will add right here a photo for you to see approximately you want it to be able to fit your foot. And you're going to be putting it a couple stitches here, 1, 2, away from that center mark. So let me put this picture and you could see what I'm talking about. Okay, so as you can see, then I just did it. So here, now, when I get to that center mark there, I'm going to go 1, 2 spaces below there. So then just to do my little chains, and these aren't real spaces, they're just like the post at the end of the your rows here. So here there's a center of approximately, and here I'm going to go 1, one single crochet, then go into my next space. This one I do go under the space. I don't go into the chain. I'm going into the actual space. So that's 2, 3, 4 into the little space there. I'm just kind of finding somewhere to stick my hook in there. Can you see that? And then 5. So you're going to have 5 little stitches there. Excuse me, not 5, 4. I'm totally losing it, people. I'm looking ahead at my notes. And so here in the front, you just want to have 4 little stitches there where it holds on there, 4 single crochets. Here you have 4. And here I had 10 chains. You're going to put this on your foot, you know, when you do the 10 chains and attach the first one to see how it fits. Now here, once again, for myself, my foot is narrow, so I'm going to do my 10 chains. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Everybody's going to be a little bit different because my foot is like so super skinny. So now here you can just find, I had my ruler up here and now I can't find it. I'm just going to find something that is kind of this, you know, almost the same. I can count my stitches here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the 6th stitch I had it. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that would be my 6th stitch right there. I'm just going to put it the stitch marker so you could see. So now once I do my, for me it was 10 chains, you might be a little bit different. Everybody's foot's different, so I can't give you an exact. Because even though I were a size 7 and you were a size 7, your foot might be wider or whatever. So here, once you do your stitches, how many chains you're going to need, you're going to try it on. And then here, I'm going to go ahead, attach here, do my single crochet, and then I'm going to do a single crochet over the next 3 so I could have the same 4 here. So here's 1, 2, 3, go through both loops. I know it's kind of awkward holding the hook like this, and then 4. Usually I would just be crocheting with this on my lap so it wouldn't be so awkward, but here I need to do it in front of the camera. Okay. So now here, we've attached our sandal there, right there, on both sides. And now here, once again, I'm going to do 60 chains, just like I had here. So I'm going to go ahead and do the 60 chains, and then we'll come back, and then I'll show you how we finish this little sandal. Okay, so here I've done my 60 chains. So both sides look the same, just like that, okay? And your foot's going to go in here, so these little straps are going to help hold it. So once you've done your 60 chains, we're going to go back and chain right, do a stitch right into those same chains. And when we come up here on top of these 4 stitches and these 4 stitches, when we come over our single crochets, we're going to do a single crochet over the single crochets, okay? So here, what you're going to do is we want to make this chain a little thicker. Let me see here. My yarn is getting kind of tangled there. So here I'm going to go ahead and go back into that chain. Let me show you what I mean. So here I'm going to go into the starting at the second chain from the hook. That's 1, 2. I'm going to go into that chain and then just slip through it. Go into the next chain, slip through, do a slip stitch. Into the next chain, slip stitch. And all the way, all your 60 chains, I'm going to go into the chain, next chain, pull through, and I'm doing a slip stitch. And you can see here how our ties are getting stronger and a little bit thicker, but not so thick where they're going to bother you. Okay, here I'm coming to those 4, the single crochet stitches. And here you can see how much thicker this looks. It looks almost like an I-cord, which will make it last longer compared to this one that has not had the stitches done through it through slip stitch, so you could see how much nicer, and this should be able to last you a lot longer. So this is what it looks like when you slip stitch through the chain, and this is what it looks like when it doesn't. So this makes a big difference. So now when I came here, let me get here to my stitches, to the single crochet. You're going to single crochet over the single crochet and then just continue slip stitching through the chains, single crochet over the single crochet, slip stitch through the chain, and then you know you do your single crochets there. So here okay, here I've come to the end, so I'm back where I started here at my chain, and you can see that this is all done. So here now I'm just going to go ahead and cut my yarn. I'm leaving it a little long so I could weave it in at the end, just like this. I'm going to cut it down, okay? And I know a lot of people say you should never make a knot, but I know that's not really crocheting. It's like macrame then, but I'm just going to do a little slip not there so it doesn't fall apart. And then I'm going to sew my tails in here. I'm going to sew my tails in here, and then it will be ready to wear. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, get my needles, sew those tails in, and then I'll come back and I'll show you a picture of what it looks like when it's worn. So thanks so much for watching. Please be sure to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Hit that like button. And remember always that God loves you.